The height h of the right triangle drawn from the vertex of the right angle divides the hypotenuse into two segments with lengths in the 9 to 16 ratio. Calculate the perimeter of the right triangle as a function of height h. I will pause this video for a couple of seconds so that you guys can try to solve it, and then we will continue. Alright, let's get to the solution. So first, let us draw the right triangle ABC, and let's say that the right angle is at the vertex C. From the C, we can draw down the height h of the triangle, which will intersect our hypotenuse at the point D. Now we can say that the segment AD is equal to M, and the segment DB is equal to N. We can see that the ratio between M and n is equal to 9 to 16. So first, we will multiply the outer terms, so that's 16 times m, which equals to multiplication of the inner terms, that's 9 times n. And now we will divide both sides with 16, and we get that m is equal to 9n over 16. Now, if we take a look at our triangle, we can see that the height h is dividing our triangle into two separate right triangles, triangle DCB and triangle ADC. If we take a look at the angle at the vertex B of the triangle DBC and the angle at the vertex C of the triangle ADC, we can conclude that these two angles are the same, because both lines of these two angles are perpendicular to each other. Therefore, that means that two angles must be the same. That means that the triangle DCB and the triangle ADC must be similar triangles. Now we can apply the rule of similarity of these two triangles, which states that the ratio between the legs of these two triangles must be the same. So therefore, h over n must be equal to m over h. Now, if we cross multiply, we get that h square is equal to n times m. We can now replace the value of m in our function below, and we get that h square is equal to n times 9n over 16. And that is equal to 9n squared over 16. That means that h is equal to square root of 9n squared over 16, and that is 3n over 4. Therefore, we can conclude that n is equal to 4h over 3. Now, if we get back to our first line, and we just switch the value of n, we get that m is equal to 9 times 4h over 3 over 16. We can cancel 9 and 3, and we get that is 12h over 16. We can simplify 12 and 16 with 4, and we get that m is equal to 3h over 4. And this way, we got the values of segments n and m in a function of the height h. Now, let's try to calculate all the sides of our right triangle ABC. Let's say that the side CB is equal to the value of A, side AC is equal to the value of B, and the hypotenuse AB is equal to the value of C. If we take a look at the triangle DCB, we will see that it is a right triangle, and therefore we can apply the Pythagorean theorem. So A square is equal to h square plus n square. We can now switch the value of n, and we get that a square is equal to h square plus 4h over 3 squared. That is equal to h square plus 16h square over 9. Now we can expand h square with 9 so that we can get a common denominator, and we get that is 25h square over 9. Of course, this means that a is equal to square root of 25h squared over 9, and we get that the leg a of our triangle is equal to 5h over 3. So we got the value of the leg of our triangle in a function of height h, and this is exactly what we wanted to do. Let's do exactly the same thing for the leg b. Now we will look at the triangle ADC. We can see that that triangle is also a right triangle. Of course, again, a Pythagorean theorem applies. So b squared equals to h squared plus m squared. Now we can switch the value of m, and we get that b squared is equal to h squared plus 3h over 4 squared. And that is h squared plus 9h squared over 16. We will again expand h squared, this time with 16, so that we can get the common denominator, and we get the result of 25h squared over 16. That means that b is equal to square root of 25h squared over 16, and we get that the leg b is equal to 5h over 4. In this way, we got the value of the leg b as a function of the height h. And finally, we can find the value of hypotenuse c by adding segments n and m. So if we switch the value of n and the value of m in our function, we get that c is equal to 4h over 3 plus 3h over 4. We can expand the first fraction with 4 and the second fraction in 3 in order to get the common denominator. So that is 16h over 12 plus 9h over 12, which equals to 25h over 12, and this is the value of our hypotenuse c in the function of the height h. Now all that we need to do is to calculate the perimeter of our triangle. Of course, the perimeter is equal to the sum of all sides of the triangle, and if we switch the values, we get that perimeter is equal to 5h over 3 plus 5h over 4 plus 25h over 12. We can expand the first fraction with 4 and the second fraction with 3 to get the common denominator as before, and we get that p is equal to 20h over 12 plus 15h over 12 plus 25h over 12, and that is 60h over 12. We can divide 60 and 12 and get that p is equal to 5h. This means that perimeter of our triangle is equal to 5 times of its height. And this is our answer. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you did, give it a like, share or subscribe, and see you all in the next one. Bye!